Let's take a quick tour of the EndNote screen. The left-hand panel, also referred to as the Groups panel, is where you can see your references sorted into different groups. The first selection is All References, and this is the default selection when you open the program. Below that, we have options to view any recently added references, anything that's unfiled, meaning any references that haven't been added to one of your groups. You can also view trash or deleted items, and below that you'll have your groups and group sets. We have a separate video that will talk you through creating groups and group sets. I'm just going to go back and select all references again. Now in the middle panel, we can see the details of the references displaying from our selected group. So we can see I can scroll this bar across and there's more information available. And if I'd like to see additional columns, I can add them using a right mouse click. I'll scroll back. If we select a reference, we can see the right-hand panel has now been populated. And in this panel, you've got three tabs: Summary, Edit, and PDF. I'll go back to the Summary tab, and on here we're getting just that, a summary of the reference we've selected. This summary will list the title, the author, publication details, and where available, also the DOI and the abstract. At the bottom of the summary tab, we'll have it will display our selected referencing style, or our selected output style, as well as options to insert and copy the citation. Below this, we're getting a preview of this record. So this will display the reference formatted in the selected referencing style. If you can't see the preview, sometimes this section of this panel is minimized to the bottom, and you just need to use the upwards pointing arrow to expand that out and check the preview. You can also adjust the width of these panels at any time to suit your preferences, simply by hovering and clicking and dragging over the dividing lines. Now, most of the controls and options for your library and your references are accessible from the menu at the top left. I won't talk through all these menu options now. In the later videos, there'll be different options used and they'll be explained as they're relevant to the demonstrations. But just to point out that in the middle panel, you also do have the option to search within your library, and you can expand out an advanced search as well and return to the simple search. And below this, we have a series of icons. Most commonly, you'll use the first icon to insert a citation into your document, and use the second icon to add a new reference manually to your EndNote library. The other four icons are used to share a group, export references, search online, and use Web of Science. You're unlikely to need this functionality, at least not as a beginner using EndNote. And just a little further on the online search icon. I wouldn't recommend you use this feature to search the Charles Sturt Library collection. This feature doesn't search comprehensively. It won't give you a reliable indication of the resources we have available. The best way for you to search our collections is to use Primo Search or the library databases from our website.